So let's go and work through another full strength colony.
So how long is it?
She can last for 2 or 3 years. Usually at least 1.5 years. Sometimes as many as 3. We typically replace our queens after 2 years. In the second year, we'll get rid of them and give the hive a new queen. Unless she's so good that I want to keep her for a breeder queen. So give all the mess here. Right, if she produces a lot of honey, is productive, and you can get lots of bees or splits from her. The brood remains healthy, they stay free of parasites and pests. There's hive beetles again. Okay, so put some smoke on the top. Get the smoke, and now I'm just going to look around the colony and evaluate this one, see how it's doing. I pulled brood out of this colony to make that new cup that we looked at most recently. Okay, that's a nice cup of honey. And there's some drones. Bigger eyes.
And heck, can you tell
fuzzy butts.
They're big. They're bigger body.
Mm-hmm.
Is that the way you kill a queen?
That's a drone. Yeah, that's the male bee.
But you kill a drone.
Yeah, by the shape.
By the shape.
Okay. Yeah, he's got a blunt tail, broader. They've got honey and pollen on. Until he's ready to fly out and mate. Sometimes, yeah, that's right. That's right. The bees will actually take care of him. He's pretty much incapable of doing anything for himself. That's a beautiful common brood. See how it's laid up solidly from sidewall to sidewall? I mean, it really is just nothing but solid brood. So this is a really good queen. I like her so far. She's definitely doing her job. I don't know whether you can see down in there or not, but there are eggs and young larvae in there.
Yes, I see that.
Alright, so typically, I might just choose to stop right there. I could put the hive back together and I'd say, okay, I've checked it. It's got adequate honey. You know, you feel the weight of it until it's got enough honey, right? Not having to actually look at each comb. Since we're doing this lesson, I was going to show you a few other things. Okay, see the drone brood here? It looks a little different. That's a drone brood. See how much bigger those cells are?
Oh.
To accommodate the larger drones?
Okay.
So right around the bottom here, on the corner here, that's a drone brood. This is sealed brood there. All that's going to hatch out into baby bees here in a few days. So this colony is going to be even more populous very soon. They're thriving. Nice and calm. Flying up and again, beautiful solid common brood, right? So this will in another 2 or 3 days we'll just this one comb will add another. These are all pupae now, but underneath the caps there? Yeah, the So it's egg for 3 days, larva for 6 days, and pupae for 12 days, for a total of 21 days from start to finish. Can you see the face?
Yes.
It's not colored yet, so it's still 2 or 3 days away. But very soon, the eyes will be pigmented as it gets closer to hatching, and then the cuticle will start to darken. The wings will more fully develop. If we pull that out now, we'd be able to see legs on that developing pupa that we wouldn't be able to see wings. I mean, we'd be able to see legs, but not wings yet. The wings wouldn't come along until the next 24 hours or so. I would light a smoker until you get in the habit of doing it. I would light a smoker and leave it, you know, give them a puff of smoke and leave the smoker next to the beehive so that it was kind of, the smoke was drifting over the entrance. You're going to try to mow right up next to them. Either that, or you might get up early in the morning and stuff the entrance with newspaper. Then once you're done mowing, you can come back and take that out.
I heard somebody say that they don't sting you at night.
No, that's not true. I mean, if you mess with them at night, they can sting you anytime. And not only that, they'll crawl at night. So you can be out, if you're out trying to mess with them at night, you got to be extra careful because, first of all, you can't see as well what's going on. And they can crawl up your pants leg or up your shirt sleeve. They're much more prone to do that kind of thing in the dark. And then I had the unpleasant surprise of realizing that you get lots of bees in your clothes. Okay, well, there's not much I can do for this hive except praise it. It's in good shape. It's gonna be ready for winter. And if you want to know what your hive needs to feel like for winter, so grab this handful right here and just pick up a corner of it. Just feel what that feels like, okay? It's got quite a lot of honey in it, okay? So this colony doesn't need to make much more honey before it's ready for winter.
So you
pretty much right now. Usually I would say that I would have already done that, maybe a month ago, or 2 or 3 months ago. Yeah, but see how quickly they've drawn this out? This was only put in there 2 or 3 days ago, and they've almost drawn this out. And they've started to put honey in right there. That's honey that they're putting in. You see that? So they're actually on a fall nectar flow right now, so that's good. When they've got flying weather, they will fly out and see what's going on. But they won't be too active until the first plants in the springtime start to bloom. Again, that's fresh honey right there, too. I bet the queen's come up here and started to place a few eggs up here as well. Yep, sure enough. Solid comb of brooded. See, that's full of larvae.
Oh yeah, long skin.
That's all we need to do for this hive.
It goes right out.
Yeah, and a little practice helps too. I don't have to do this, but I'm just going to clean this burkin along this frame. Make it a little easier to get into next time.
Yeah.
And we didn't see as many hive beetles in this hive because it's got enough bees in there that it's doing a better job of keeping them out or corralled once they invade. So I'm not going to worry about trying to get it. when you get your colony in the springtime, you're probably going to have to feed it for the first little bit, just to keep it going and get it off the ground to a good start.
First little bit, 2 weeks.
Maybe a month. But yeah, at least 2 weeks. So a couple feeders of syrup, or maybe 3 or 4 feeders of syrup, depending on where you are, what the rate was. I suspect it'll get off to a quick start in NSU. You probably won't have to feed more than 2 weeks, maybe 3. Then after that, just let them grow. And once they fill up the box in the bottom, okay, all the combs are, you know, relatively full of honey or brood, and there's a comfortable population of bees in there, then you can put another super. Another unit. Yep, another level.
Now, is this the best way to raise them, or is it a better way those
feeders? This is much easier for a beginner bee. Go out there and look at the top bar, and I'll explain to you what I mean about it being tricky.